In this video class, I'm just going to do a recap of the items we've covered, but this will assist us in the next video where we will be dealing with the correction of errors. So just want to go back, do a recap of the books of prime entry. How many books of prime entry do we have? Remember, books of prime entry, that's where a transaction is first recorded before transactions are posted to the ledger. So we have the sales day book. Okay, what we record in the sales day book? That's where we record credit, sales. Then source of information, that's an invoice. That's the first book. And other book we have purchases. Remember, it's purchases day book. What we record? Credit, purchases. Source of information, again, that's an invoice. Okay? We also have sales returns. Remember, they are all day book. Sales returns day book. Don't mind my writing. Sales returns it's for sales returns. Goods previously sold, now returned by customers. Source of information, that's a credit note. We have purchases returns. Purchases returns. That's for returns. Outward. Source document. We send a debit note to the supplier. Okay? We have the cash book. Item check cash receipts and paid. In the cash book we record cash received and cash paid. Source of information, it can be a check stamp or we can use a receipt. We have a petty cash. Petty cash item. Small transactions or low value transactions. Okay? Then source. Then lastly, we have the general journal. So these are what you call the books of prime entry. So in your books of prime entry, this is where a transaction is first recorded before it's transferred to the ledger. So a transaction is first recorded before it's transferred to the ledger. So we have seven books of prime entry. We have seven books of prime entry. Then, after the information has been recorded in the books of prime entry, we now transfer that information which is in the books of prime entry to what we call the ledger. Transactions are now recorded in the ledger accounts. Okay. How many ledgers do we have? We have three main. We have the sales ledger. This is for personal accounts of customers. The sales ledger is for personal accounts of customers. We have the purchases ledger. This is for personal accounts of suppliers. Lastly, we have the general ledger. So in the general ledger, that's where we record all other transactions. Remember, which are not personal accounts of customers or personal accounts of suppliers. So please understand this. Remember, I want to build on the correction of errors in control. So the sales ledger is for personal accounts of customers. Purchases ledger is for personal accounts of suppliers. Okay. Then we have the general ledger. That's where we record all other transactions which are not personal accounts of suppliers and personal accounts of customers. Okay. So that's just a brief summary why it's going to guide us when I'm dealing with the topic I want to deal with, which is the correction of errors.